want to welcome you again to our science demonstration this morning entitled The Baseline. And this demonstration is based on this verse in Genesis 1:28, where we read, "And God blessed them and said unto them, Be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue it. And have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth on the earth." Next slide, which would include every living thing were to subdue. Let me back up. It said every living thing that moveth, but over the fish, and over the fowl, and over the things on the earth. And I think that might include the plants. Also, beautiful flowers, as we see in slide 3. Here's in slide 4, a painting, but it's a beautiful painting of a duck. And then slide 5, we have a little family of birds learning to live on their own, but still hoping mother or dad will come by with some food. Slide 6, of course, is a sea creature that we love, the dolphins. Slide 7. I'm a little partial to parrots. That's a cynical parrot there. We are to have dominion over these things. Slide 22 is a beautiful garden from Holland that many people visit. The land has been sculpted and carved to show its beauty. And slide 9 represents things that we can gather from the vegetable garden. Slide 10 is a picture of a mountain scene. Subdue. I'm in slide 11 now. Subdue means, basically, to manage, to understand, to organize the earth, which is okay so far. But it means to bring it under control. And the Hebrew word that we translate subdue means to serve by force, if necessary. Now just think for a minute. You really can't reason with the tigers and the lions and the dolphins very well. You can't, surely can't reason with the plants that are growing, the trees and the bushes. You can't say to them, you would be better off if you grew this way or planted yourself over here. You can't reason with them. You must subdue them by force if necessary to produce from this earth what God intends. Now let's look at slide 12. One thing that gives us understanding about our world is something we call pH. Next slide. pH means power of hydrogen. Next slide. And it is the measurement of the strength of acids and bases by the level of their activity of their hydrogen ions. Next slide. The pH of water is 7, and it is neutral. It's neither basic nor acidic. Next slide. The pH of blood is close to that. It's 7.35 up to 7.45. So blood is slightly acidic. Basic. Slide 17. The pH of lemon juice and of Coca-Cola or any cola is about 3, which means it's acidic. And the pH of oven cleaner is way on the other end of the scale. It's 14, which means it's very alkaline or very basic. Next slide. Now, the demonstration we're going to do involves some water, some liquid starch, some iodine solution, vitamin C tablets, and bleach. And the purpose of it is to show you the difference between a solution that's acidic and a solution that's basic or alkaline. Because this is part of the world that we are to subdue, and we can subdue it and organize it and arrange it when we understand it better. So the first thing that we want to do is have 2 glasses. And in these 2 glasses, we're going to move it over here so it won't be so much in the way. We're going to use distilled water, and we'll use about 120 to 130 milliliters in each glass of distilled water. So I'm going to pour that in here, and a bit about fills it halfway, and pour this one in here. And then into each one we're going to put an iodine solution. Now, if you know very much about iodine, you know that it has a particular color. And we're going to put about 2 milliliters, which is a little hard to measure exactly. So what I do is I just kind of fill the bottom of my measuring, and there it goes in there, and we'll stir it up. A little more in this one. And it makes it kind of a yellow color. Now, just a moment here. Move my mic over. Get my measuring, my stirring rod. This is iodine solution. It's acidic. Now, the next thing we want to do is put a little bit of liquid starch in one of these glasses. About the same amount, just enough to cover the bottom. And you will see that this color, which is kind of yellowish, I suppose I could add a little more water to make it look a little more yellowish. But when we add the starch to this particular glass, the color is going to change. It's going to change to a dark blue or a green. It's going to darken, and that's because the starch is alkaline or basic, and it's mixing with the acid, and the two are mixing together, and the color changes. Now, into each one of these, I'm going to put a vitamin C tablet, and that's going to change the composition also of what's happening to the iodine. It's going to release an electron that's going to change the molecule of each iodine in there into an ion. And it will take a little longer in this one, but if we give it time, we will see. It's starting to lighten up already. I don't know if you can see that on the film, but the vitamin C is releasing. Oh, it's looking really nice. It's changing color. Can you see that? It's lighting up. And if you keep your eyes on that, you're going to see it like that go clear. And I'm going to stir. Oops, it's starting to, the water. Now, the iodine is still in there, but now it's perfectly white in this particular glass. And that's because the vitamin C is releasing electrons so that it changes the iodine molecules that are in this particular glass. And over here where the starch is, it's doing the same thing. But the starch isn't changed. But if we give it time, oh, I see it's lighting up. Can you see that? Look at that, the purple. It's going to go away. It's working. Now, the starch is still there. That's not going to change colors. And that the starch was, liquid starch was rather blue. But the iodine that was there has accepted the electrons released by the vitamin C. Now, if we put a dab of bleach in here, that's going to change what happens. It's going to negatively affect the electrons that are now working in this particular glass, and you will see the color come back. Now, it won't come back and stay because the vitamin C continues to release electrons, but if you watch closely, you'll see. See? Look at that. But it's not going to stay because the vitamin C is still working. Now, I just like to see that so much. I tried to make it happen again, and it didn't really happen again. See, no matter how much bleach I put in, the vitamin C is activated. Oh, that worked. Let me try it over here on this one. I got some brown reaction from the stirrer. Let's see if we can get the iodine to show up again. And it did for a little bit, but it won't because the vitamin C is still working. Now, the reason I'm showing that to you This helps us understand how bases and acids work together and that they're different and they're on this scale. Water, I remember, is neutral and their bases are react with acids and make a change in the chemical composition of a solution. But God, we are all stained. Let's move on to the next slide or two. Well, let me give you the explanation again on slide 19. The iodine turns the water yellow. We saw that it was a deep yellow, dark yellow here. The starch reacts with the iodine, changing its color to blue-black, or changing its pH from an acid to a base. The vitamin C gives an electron to each of the iodine atoms to form an iodide ion with a negative charge, and the color becomes colorless. Slide 20. The bleach removes the electrons from the iodide ions, returning the ion back to the iodine atom, and yellow color returns, but it's brief because the vitamin C continues to work. And now let's move on. You can do the same experiment with beet juice, with red cabbage juice. Cook the red cabbage for about 20, 30 minutes and pour off the juice and use that, and you can see the difference between a base and an acid and how it reacts. But the purpose of all this is our lives, in slide 23, tell us, we're darkened with sin. We're like that old glass of iodine that was brown, dark yellow and brown. But God wants us to be pure and clean, and He offers to do that to us, just like the vitamin C helped this solution clear up. He will clear up our lives, take our sins away if we depend on Him and ask Him to come into our hearts. If that Ten Commandments law, that moral law, is residing in our hearts, as we're going to talk about in just a little bit. So, this illustration shows acids and bases, yes, in our earth and natural environment, but it also illustrates how God wants to make our lives pure and clean and take out all the darkness of sin. Thank you for joining us. We'll have another demonstration next Sabbath, Lord willing. May God bless you.